Mrs. Joseph's. I have an appointment to see Paul Bladen. Hello, hashtag waiting.
Taxi.
Where exactly? And for how long? What's your name, then?
What are you doing here, Harriet?
It's Moby. He's not himself, Percy.
Not himself? Excuse me.
How do you know he's not himself? Who is he?
Yep, folks, still only me.
Chloe, those were the wrong notes again.
Sorry I'm late, guys. Trouble with a stud.
Don't you just hate that?
Right, who's next?
Here we go. Come on, little fella.
What's his name?
Hodge.
So, you are local hotshot.
Oh, got a feisty one here.
Taught him well.
Yeah, I see that. So, what made you take up residence in Coffin Dodger County?
Timing was right.
Smacks of a broken heart, you ask me. No. Actually, I take it back. This is everything you always dreamed of, isn't it? Self-made woman, you work your butt off, prove all the doubters wrong, and then jack it all in for the rural idyll.
Well, aren't you a cocky little ray of sunshine? Fancy yourself as the new animal or people whisperer?
No.
Well, if it's free PR you're after...
Dinner, actually.
You can just...
You know what? I'm sorry. I talk too much and I have no filter. Just strike that. Forget I said
something. No. Maybe I was a little hasty. I have a few trust issues.
So you did get your fingers burnt, huh?
More of a full-body arson attack.
Just the drink, then?
No, actually, the dinner thing's good.
Great. What about the cat?
You want me to bring Hodge?
No, I meant what's the problem with the cat?
Oh, he's just not himself.
Well, Jack Pomfret, would you listen to you? All right. I can't hear you. What? Look, call me when you get to a landline.
Agatha.
Cast off.
Not that ill, then?
Fit as a fiddle. Well, apart from the discomfort caused by the rectal thermometer.
Eating.
Anyway, I just wanted to see what the fuss was about.
And?
Guess who's bagged not one, but two dates in one day?
Mrs. Joseph's? She's a dirty ticket.
Me, actually. Dinner at 7 with Vet Steamy. So I better start getting myself ready.
James II, one, I take it?
Well, I didn't have much luck with James I. To be honest, I think that ship has well and truly sailed. Not that it was ever in the harbour in the first place. No, actually, it's an old PR fling looked me up. Jack the Lad Pomfret.
Jack? What did he want?
I don't know. We're going to meet tomorrow in Merchester and reminisce about the good old bad old days. What? What is wrong with you? Got a problem with that? I mean, you've hardly cracked a smile since you got here.
That's the third time this week. You've got to get that dodgy socket sorted.
Where do you think I'm seeing the vet?
But Tewkes was fine yesterday.
Yeah, I'm afraid he really is quite ill. He won't feel a thing, though, I promise. It's definitely for the best. Okay.
Hello, I'm trying to get a hold of Paul. Who am I speaking to, please? His wife?
Oh, so sorry I'm late. Wow, you look lovely, by the way. Is everything all right?
No, everything is not all right. I've just spoken to your wife. I called your home phone and she answered.
I'm separated, that'll be Philippa.
Philippa? Who's that then? Second wife? Mistress? What?
My sister, actually, and her warped idea of a joke. She just dropped by and announced and was cross that I was going out, which is why I'm late.
Do I look like I was born yesterday?
I'm serious. Cross my heart. Look, I'll call her if you like. Do you want to speak to her or shall I?
Actually, let's just leave it. Shall we start again?
Great.
Oh, you can't say that. That's terrible. No, you're saying that you don't like pets.
I'm not.
You are.
I am not. I'm saying I'm better with larger farm and working animals, and my dream is to one day open a hospital for them.
Aww.
Which I will name after you.
What? Whoa. Oh, wait a minute. Very serious face. Oh, Paul, I think I should probably go. I haven't left any milk for our Hodge.
Cats can go months without liquid.
Yeah, but he gets lonely.
Yeah, you can go decades without company. I mean, the cats aren't going to... Survivors. If a nuclear bomb went off the next day, you'd find a cat on the bonnet of the nuclear reactor.
Nuclear reactors don't have bonnets.
I'm not a bonnet expert.
Are you not?
Not anymore, no.
I'm expecting a phone call from Madagascar. Paul, I have to go.
Oh, thank you for a lovely evening. It was delightful. My treat next time. Yeah.
Easy. None of you write a note, don't you worry. Said you were thriving.
So tell me, what are you doing this side of London? You're going to be coming out in a rash soon.
Oh, you know, bit of this, bit of that. I'll explain why, but what can I get you? The usual? Double macchiato with a twist, yeah?
Oh!
Sorry.
Bill!
Paul Bladen. You went out with him last night.
No, I didn't.
Agatha, you were seen in the pub.
Yeah, that Paul Bladen.
Did you, go back to his place?
Excuse me, what kind of a question is that?
He's dead, Agatha.
Oh.
He was about to perform a minor operation on one of Lord Pendlebury's horses. He seems to have injected himself with horse tranquilizer. It must have been a tragic accident. The syringe went straight into his heart. Apparently the anaesthetic's thousands of times more potent than morphine. What did you know about him?
Not a lot. He had a sister, try his sister.
He doesn't have a sister, he's an only child.
Right. Oh, I must have got that wrong then.
Do you want your coffee?
Why was Bladen alone? Where was Lord Pendlebury or any of his staff? And why did Bladen tell me that he had a sister when he clearly didn't? Whoever I spoke to on the phone was lying. She said he was his wife.
Did you see Jack?
Briefly, but not really, no. Bladen wasn't stupid, though, was he? I mean, why would he inject himself with a deadly anaesthetic? I smell a rat.
Well, that'll be a first. Well, you did go out with a murderer. And now a murder victim. You're like one of those Black Widow spiders.
I must remember that.
Oh,
Yeah, I asked him to come and look at your dodgy socket.
I thought maybe for some reason you were ignoring me.
Me? No, why? I was... When I'm... No. Why do I feel the need to explain myself?
Aggie's caught a whiff of murder in the air. It's been another death, you know.
I heard. Poor Bladen. Yeah, Radio Gene. I swear that gross is more informative than the internet. And there's no shortage of people with motives.
Like who?
Half the fishwives in Carsley, apparently. Never mind their jealous husbands.
And Mrs. Josephs.
Wasn't after a bit of juky-juke with Mrs. Josephs as well, was he?
No. But he had Tukes put down.
Oh, not really. I like that cat. Even if he did have the breath of Satan.
I should check on her, actually. Make sure she's okay.
So, maybe we should start by checking out Pendlebury in the scene of the crime.
I beg your pardon?
That's what you do, isn't it?
You normally run a mile when I start talking about murder.
First time for everything.
He always comes running when I tap his bowl.
So, what did the vet say?
He said... What did he say now? I can't remember. Just that it was for the best.
Oh, I'm so sorry. He was so lovely.
Grumpy bugger. You know what he said just before he died? Make sure you keep using the Voltarol on your shoulder. Oh, was that my Stan?
So, what was Bladen like? I heard about your date.
Oh, did you? Well, he seemed okay, I think. He asked a lot of questions about me and talked about his dream of opening up a hospital for medium to large animals. Said he didn't really like pets.
That's a bit odd, isn't it? For a vet, I think this really needs to be done.
So do you know his nibs here then, or what?
No, but I know his daughter, Silly. Hmm? Cecilia, everyone calls her Silly.
Oh, God, give me strength. Lord Pendlebury, Agatha Raisin and James Lacey from Carsley. We're here collecting on behalf of children in Africa.
Oh, you're wasting your time, I'm afraid. I don't like children. Too many of them. Good day.
Fine-looking stables you have here, sir. I'm something of a horseman myself. I was in the household division.
Mounted?
Lifeguard.
Oh. Well, let me give you a tour.
It's a fantastic setting.
Thank you. Pendlebury's had red horses here since the Reformation. You must be very proud.
Excuse me. Could I have a quick word?
No. I gather you had an incident here. One of your horses have an accident.
Oh, no. That bet. Thank you. He was getting to operate.
It's a bit careless, isn't it?
Clearly. But accidents do happen.
Why was no one around to help him, if you don't mind my asking? Seems strange. Bladen must have known that you can't operate on a horse on your own.
No, of course not. Tell the truth, I forgot he was coming. And it was a stable lad's day off, so there was no one here.
Is that a fact?
It is.
How did you get along with him? Bladen, I mean.
Preferred his partner, Rice. Less cocky. Shall we go on? My daughter, Cecilia.
James, how nice to see you.
Silly.
Pendlebury is lying.
But what possible reason could he have for killing him?
Well, I don't know that yet, do I? Maybe Bladen was shagging his daughter. Either way, he's a suspect. And so is she.
Silly? On what grounds?
Too beautiful. You can't be that beautiful without being deranged.
Oh, that's brilliant.
It makes total sense. Everywhere you go, everyone you see, people's jaws dropping, messes with your head. It's like Prince Charles with paint.
Maybe this is a bad idea.
Too late, my friend. You've committed. Right. I need to talk to Bladen's partner about Pendlebury.
That's about it, really. Obviously, all the medical records are here, and you know your way around all the IT. Yes.
What happened to Miss Mensah?
Chloe, she handed in a notice.
Did she know? That's convenient.
Far from it.
So were her and Paul at it? Terribly sorry, it's just that Paul and I had dinner last night and I'm finding it a little difficult to process.
I think we're all struggling.
What was the problem with the horse?
He had a respiratory condition Paul wanted to operate. One of Pendlebury's staff should have been there to assist.
I mean, Paul wouldn't have made a mistake like that with such a lethal anaesthetic.
Oh, I've been going over and over that in my head. I can only assume Paul started prepping on the assumption that the stable hands would return and... I don't know. We'll probably never know.
Is there any reason his lordship might not have wanted the operation to go ahead?
Cherokee wouldn't have been able to sire for a while, I suppose.
Why is that important?
Pendlebury breeds horses. He needs the money it brings him. Excuse me.
Thank you.
Hi.
Hi.
Oh,
sorry. yeah, a couple of onions, please, Jean. Pound of tomatoes. Oh, and I need to know exactly which villagers have been out for dinner with Paul Bladen since he moved here.
Right you are.
Ooh, two tips. Ladies. Josephine.
Silly? No, not at all. Good to hear from you. Tomorrow? Yeah, no, that'd be fine. I'll see you then. Bye.
Guess what?
What?
Lord Pendlebury used his horse Cherokee as a stud.
And this is relevant because...
Because an operation would put Horsey out of action and lose Pendlebury thousands.
Huh. Okay, I'll ask Silly about it. She wants to meet for a drink tomorrow night.
And you said yes, did you?
Do you have a problem with me seeing her for a drink?
No, I don't have a problem.
Hey, Jim, how'd you get on with the fishwives?
Okay, so they are, I mean, present company excluded, obviously. Emma Comfrey.
Can't be her, she's on a cruise. Next.
And Mrs. Harriet Parr.
Harriet Parr. Oh, well, that explains why Percy was so snippy about the goldfish. So, in terms of suspects, we have got Lord Pendlebury, Percy, and or Harriet Parr, who is going to be at the cheese and cider tasting tonight. Tragic, wasn't it? What happened to Paul Bladen? Such a breath of fresh air.
Was he? Can't say I noticed.
Josephine.
Tell me. Did Percy know about Harry?
Oh, he caught them. Canoodling.
Harriet's homemade hooch. It can strip paint. Mm. Have some cheese and biscuits to soak it up. Mrs. Joseph.
I need a sponge to soak that up.
Justice. A dish best served cold.
I think you mean revenge.
Karma. What goes around.
I think that's karma.
Much karma now he's dead. Call on me first thing tomorrow. I'll tell you everything you need to know about Paul Ruddy Bladen.
I love you! I know you're in there! I love you! Look, I'm staying nearby and I'm not leaving until I've seen you. Do you hear me? Roy?
Roy?
Roy!
What do you mean, Roy? Jack! You turned Jack the Lad Pomfret. That man was straighter than a Roman road. What did you do? No, don't answer that.
He was just another guy. It was just another party.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, weekend.
Mm-hmm.
All right, fortnight in Morocco, but how was I to know? He's left his wife and everything.
What? Really? Jack had a wife? You have finished it,
haven't you?
I can't. It'll break his heart. You saw him. Oh, what do I do?
Man up. Actually, woman up. Roy, you have got to tell him the truth. Hello? Mrs. Josephs? Who on God's earth would want to kill Mrs. Josephs?
No one. Mrs. Josephs was a diabetic. It looks like she made a mistake injecting herself.
So it wasn't murder?
Why would it be?
Because last night, she said that she had something to tell me about Bladen.
Agatha, go home. We'll be over in a while to take a statement. Okay?
Okay. She said justice was a dish best served cold, and then she mentioned korma.
Chicken or lamb?
Really?
You're missing the point.
I'll be the judge of that.
What's wrong, Wong? Earlier on, you told me that this was natural causes. Now, what's all this? You think it's murder, don't you?
I don't think anything. Until someone tells me exactly what to think, I don't think at all. And neither should you. Constable.
Okay. Forensics found scuff marks on the stairs, all the way up from the front room to the bathroom, as if Mrs. J was dragged upstairs.
So why do that? Unless someone had given her a lethal dose and made it look like it was an accident.
But why? What's the connection to Bladen or Pendlebury?
And what did Mrs. Josephs want to tell me?
Could anyone have overheard her arranging to meet you?
Most of the women at the Carsley Ladies Society. Sarah, Josephine, Harriet Parr. Harriet Parr, of course. Maybe Mrs. Josephs had something on Harriet about Bladen. Does Bill see anything in his little black book about any of the neighbours seeing anyone entering Mrs. Josephs' house?
Well, no one. But it does say here the murderer could have used the field at the back of the house.
You see, the thing is, if I had murdered Mrs. Josephs by injecting her with something, I wouldn't leave that something lying about in amongst all her bottles and pills.
With you so far.
So what would I do? I would hurl it out of the car window at the first available opportunity, probably somewhere round about here.
The killer injected Mrs. Josephs with a sandal.
All right, well, have you got any better ideas?
No, but I'm supposed to be seeing Silly soon.
What are you thinking, Jem?
Yeah, I think Agatha's right, but they'd be all indecisive, wouldn't they? So they'd think about chucking it, but then they'd stop. But they would be effing and blinding. So why did she effing have to do that, a silly old bag? Why couldn't she keep her effing nose out of it so you'd be ranting?
We should take you further up the road.
Yeah, round about to here, where you'd shut the water out the car and it would land about, well, round about here, where that funny little bottle is.
No, don't touch it! You contaminate the evidence.
Epinephrine. I know about that from my army days. It's adrenaline, which, if injected, can cause a heart attack.
Oh, I knew it! Natural causes.
Which one of our motley crew of suspects would know about adrenaline?
Well, there's Pendlebury and his silly daughter. But Mrs. Harriet, butter wouldn't melt in your mouth, Parr.
Really?
Fair point. Although, she did used to be a district nurse, oh.
Well, we have to tell Bill. Right. You need to stay here and guard the bottle.
No.
You need to go and tell Bill, Roy, Jack. I'll go and confront Harriet Parr. I want to talk to you about Mrs. Josephs and Paul Bladen.
Come in.
Hello, James.
Hi. Silly. So sorry.
So, as a district nurse, you must have given out injections willy-nilly.
Yes, at times. Why are you asking?
Do you know what? I think I'm just going to cut to the chase. I know about you and Paul. And I know that Percy found out. But that didn't stop you. Which is why you took a perfectly healthy goldfish to the vets. But Percy followed you, didn't he? So you couldn't see Paul. And even that didn't stop you.
I don't know what you mean.
It was you I spoke to, wasn't it? On the phone, pretending to be his wife. What happened? Did you and Paul have a row, and did Mrs. Josephs know how you felt about him? And she threatened to tell the whole village?
No! I just wanted to see Paul. He was so young and so brave. He was going to found a veterinary hospital for medium to large animals. I could never harm him.
Get out. Just get out!
Something I wanted to ask you. Do you think there's something wrong with me? Am I not attractive?
No, not at all.
Oh, yeah, I didn't think so.
No. You're very attractive. Why would you think otherwise?
Because of Paul Bladen. I tried everything. I threw myself at him, literally. Bared my soul and more. He just wasn't interested.
But I'm sure it's not that.
Everyone thinks I'm this spoiled little rich girl, but I'm not. We're completely skint.
Is that why your father didn't want Bladen to operate?
I didn't know he didn't.
Do you know where he was when Bladen was killed?
Yeah, sure. He was with me in London. We had a meeting at the bank first thing. Oh, we didn't get back till the evening.
Oh, right. Where's Jimbo then? Anyway, so I was just telling everyone about the swearing. I was just messing about, really. And that is when we found it. Here we are, look. He's putting a marker. The bottle with the adrenaline in it used to kill Mrs. Josephs. It's probably got fingerprints on it.
What bottle?
Agatha's not going to be happy.
True, generally.
James, what are you doing here with her? You were supposed to stay with the bottle, because that could have been the incriminating evidence that could have nailed Percy.
Percy? What happened to Harriet?
Oh, never mind Harriet.
Is this the medicine bottle you told me about?
Yeah.
What? I can't believe you've told her.
No, it's fine. She was with her father when Bladen was at the farm. Which rules them out, no?
Right, OK. Well, who else have you told? Anyone else? About the bottle. Could anyone have overheard you, maybe, in the pub?
Sarah, Jean, Josephine.
Brilliant.
Loads of people.
And that woman who kept tying you up.
Excuse me, can you just... We... What woman?
The blonde with the Brummie accent.
The vet secretary?
Chloe Mabbs. Yeah, and she's after the barman.
So maybe Bladen dumped her and she wasn't happy. She would have had access to adrenaline. Right, so how do we find her?
Friday night. Jesters in Evesham, that's where everyone goes.
Yeah, I have to tell DCI Wilkes.
Must you?
What is this music?
Acid house, funk, techno trance, dubstep. There she is. Well, we can't chat to Chloe in the dance floor, can we? We need to create a distraction. Someone's going to have to go in there.
I'm in charge. Leave it to me. Thank you.
Brilliant.
Right,
What's he doing?
He's creating a distraction.
Coming through, police business out of the way, thank you. Right, Mr. DJ, cut the music. Thank you, police business. Excuse me. Away, please, make a bit of room.
Oh my sweet goodness.
A word. Were you eavesdropping on him in the pub?
Him? Do me a favour.
Why did you leave your job?
No blade and twoggle, no fun.
Did you go out with him?
No chance. He only went for rich bitches. I've not got a penny.
Nor Cecilia. Maybe that's why he didn't go for her. Whereas?
Whereas what? Harriet Parr isn't rich.
Yes, she is. Percy's so tight, she's got a fortune.
Well, why did Bladen need money?
For his animal hospital for medium to large animals. He wined them, dined them, shagged them, and then asked them for money.
Look, about Bladen, it's not like you were to know.
I don't want to talk about it. I'm going to find out who killed Mrs. Josephs because she was a good woman. And then I'm going to go and join a nunnery.
You can't do that.
Why not?
I miss all this. And I miss you.
James, you're only doing this because you're bored and you've got writer's block. I'm not stupid.
Sleep then?
Yeah. Well, I think I drifted off about five.
The cards and cakes of support are from the villagers. The flowers are from Josephine Webster. And Sarah says not to worry, there's already a search party out for Hodge.
Hodge.
Josephine Webster.
Well, she's a widow, and she's got stacks of cash. She was at the ladies' night, so she could easily have heard Mrs. Josephs talking to me. And she was in the pub when James was spouting off about the bottle. She was the one who was spreading the word about who Blaine had gone out with, but maybe, just maybe, she neglected to include herself. She's going. Where's she going?
Let's follow her.
Thank you.
doing with him?
What's he doing with her? Maybe you're right. Maybe they have got Hodge.
Park Hodge just for a second. Now listen, we all know that Bladen tried it on with every fishwife, every... lots of people, and therefore possibly her.
Let me take you through.
And as we can see, Rice is clearly enjoying her company, so what if he had a grudge against Bladen and killed him?
How can we prove that?
Well, I could go to the surgery, check the appointments book, see if he was there that morning.
What do I do?
Just a second. Excuse me. Peter Rice. So, they're booked in for dinner at 7, so they're not going to be going anywhere anytime soon. So you stay here, watch them. I'll go to the surgery, check the appointments book and have a little look for Hodge.
Well, I just stand here.
Why not? Or you could salve your conscience and, contact Jack.
Jack, what are you doing here?
This is where I've been staying.
I honestly did not want it to be like this, but at the end of the day, I shouldn't have been a coward, and I'm sorry. I didn't mean to hurt your feelings, and I never, ever wanted to cause any problems in your life. But the truth is, you and I, we're just not meant to be.
Will the woman that was asking about you earlier be joining you, sir? Blonde hair, sharp bob, lots of colour.
Straight with me.
I meant everything I said.
Yeah, I know.
Where are you and where's Agatha?
More to the point, where's the vet?
You can't kill me. The police will know.
Do you think? I'm not sure. I could have discovered you breaking into my surgery.
Why did you kill Bladen? Let alone Mrs. Josephs.
Now, she was a mistake.
A mistake?
Josephine told me she wanted to talk to you. I thought she knew something. I confronted her. She was confused. I lost my temper.
What about Bladen? Was he a mistake too?
Paul could have been a great vet, but he wanted to run before he could walk. I knew he'd be good for business. But he didn't like dealing with pets. He wanted to build an animal hospital.
And for that, he needed money. So he started fleecing women left, right and centre. Including Josephine.
Yes. I'd spent years waiting for her, waiting for the day when she saw that I was the one.
Instead, he steamed in there, he wined her and dined her and...
broke her heart. So I knew he was up at Pendlebury, so I went up there to have it out with him. And when I got there, I saw this. Why should Paul have everything? Why should he get what he wants?
You don't have the monopoly on being a sad loser. None of us get what we want. What we do is we find people who are all right. And we cling to them. Good people.
like Mrs. Joseph's.
I bet you can't even tell me her Christian name.
Oh, God!
Castration forceps.
Nice work, Gemma. I thought Tukes had...
Oh, yeah. No, I know. Mrs. J was just confused because the vet was only keeping him in overnight because he had that whiffy breath stomach thing, didn't he? Anyway, it's sorted now because Agatha's adopting him.
Where is she?
At Mrs. Joseph's.
Judith. You're gonna get snot all over your jacket.